going on, Big Ro Nation? Bro Fist, because we're starting the long teased about Spotlight series. And since this is the first episode, I will do a little bit of explanation for what this series will be, because it's a little different than what you might be thinking it is. So, back in the day, we had a thing. I'm saying back in the day like I'm a really old YouTuber, but like back like 3 years ago, there used to be this series on YouTube that a lot of these smaller channels would do. Not super small, like I was around 1 to 100, but like 1,000 plus, kind of like where I'm at now, would run these series called Shoutout Sundays. And basically, everyone had to comment below, like the video, subscribe to the people in the videos, even though no one ever did that. So it was just a way to get a bunch of subs, and then like they'll just randomly pick people out of the comments, like, all right, I'll give you a shout out, whatever. And they just do like some little thing, yeah, look how great his channel is. Like, if I can find, I won two. I think I might be able to find one of them.
Probably. First shout out of this week is going to Dan9403, who is currently at 11 subscribers. He uploads daily Fortnite streams in great quality and commentary, which indicates that he is consistent in his channel. So I'd really appreciate it if he gets
one of them. Probably not, though, because a lot of those shoutout channels got deleted by YouTube for breaking violations, which is why you won't see people doing them now, even though they were great ways to get subs. Instead, I'm going to be doing a Spotlight series, which is where I take the most underrated channels. It doesn't have to be YouTube. It can be Twitch, Mixer, Facebook Gaming. Even though I don't know if I'm going to be searching Facebook Gaming. You have to send me a link if you want to enter yourself in for that. So I'm going to go through all these channels, pick out the ones that I feel are the most underrated, like the greatest content in ratio to their small audience. So kind of like really well-made content that's not getting enough views that it should be. So for this series, you can leave a comment down below, suggest that I check out your channel, but it's not guaranteed you're going to get in. But it's also not guaranteed that you won't get in just because you weren't in one of the newest videos. There's a lot of channels out there, and if yours is a good channel and you recommend it below, maybe it'll be in the next video. I actually got a lot of good recommendations for this first episode. I posted on Reddit and Twitter, got a lot of suggestions, and I picked the first three from that group that I got in the beginning, and I hope you guys like their channels. Oh, and one more little thing. This is the Spotlight series, and I'm always telling people if they have shitty videos because their lighting sucks. Well, I was a hypocrite and never did it myself. Go back and look at my Resident Evil face cam. It's super lit well. So that's why I now have this light that will, I don't know, make the picture actually 1080p like the camera says it should be. So this new light's really cool, kind of giving me a red filter-ish now. I think it does well with the spotlight theme. But you can also, with a flick of your fingers, out in the street, they call it make it thank Green Man. Alright, so the first channel for the spotlight episode is going to be Chest Gammon, which I believe is how you pronounce it. Hey Siri, how do you pronounce Chest Gammon? Not helpful. You know, I think this channel will be best described as kind of in a more adult crash course. You know, the series where the Green Brothers would teach you like a subject. For this, he kind of does the same similar short, give you some information, but he does it on more specific topics and with a little bit more humor that couldn't be played in the classroom. So let's get a first look at one of his videos.
Sorry.
See, right off the bat, you can see the amount of effort that went into this. This man, instead of being like a talking head, as in like the Crash Course and probably other lecture videos on the internet, this man is making it wholly animated in cartoon form. You can go back again, where he does this little funny coughing bit in the beginning. Look at all the different phases his character, his little pixel art goes through. You know, that takes a lot of time. I've gone into trying to make a little animated cartoon, even for like maybe 10 seconds of a video clip, and this man did it for the whole thing, so the amount of effort that this guy put into this is, it's up there.
What was I gonna say? Oh, right. I'm depressed. I am personally a fervent fan of the features of flags and frequently find my favorites with fanfare on the walls of my apartment, but alas, being a Pennsylvania...
Well, right there we can see another great aspect of his videos. His scripts are really quick and to the point, but it's chock full of like humor, like stuff that you'd have to watch two or three times just to get all the jokes.
fanfare on the walls.
Like, how fast he goes through this? Like, to have the effort to write a script that's that kind of packed with, like, references and stuff for a 6 minute and 20 video, it's not easy. It's like a short, condensed time. He needs to fit in all these witty jokes and also, at the same time, teach us something. Why is the British flag on the flag of Hawaii? So let's move on and get some more of this. Here we see his animation style change for a little bit, showing that he puts more effort than just pixel art. Like, this is like a little crayon-esque Microsoft Paint looking thing. And right there, he does the, you know, the classic bit where you're like the audience talking from the comments and you do a kind of voice. It's always a winner. Always think it's funny.
Navy, which at this point was under the command of Captain James Cook, who, if you don't know him, was the inventor of Australia. I once had the unique up.
Well, see right there? This is where we're starting to get into the information, but he's also keeping it witty, you know? He can't just, like, straight up just give us fact after fact after fact. He does it smoothly, transitionally, while fitting in certain jokes and breaks from the information, you know, keep the audience engaged, which even in today's age with a short video like 6 minutes 20 seconds, you got to keep the audience engaged all the way through. And see fun little cartoons like this where he switches it up, uses a little stock footage background, obviously as a joke, a Denny's joke.
God damn it, this joke sucks. Luckily for when he first arrived on
the I thought the joke was alright, but Lono, self-aware humor works too. You can call out your own content. It's always funny. And that was a really clean animation. Like, that looked like something like you wouldn't ever question this. Like, I could see this like some PBS cartoon. Like, the simplistic nature of it doesn't hold anything back. It still looks clean. It looks fluid.
Apologize for the last time we came here. I know things got off to a bit of a rocky start, but hey, I have a makeup.
See, and this is just like a funny way of kind of summarizing the actual historical event by making it kind of a funny, goofy interaction where they like sarcastically mentioning their previous details, but he does it in a comical way where like they're actually face-to-face meeting something that probably didn't happen in history, but it still gets the point across.
Constant state of flux until they were finally finalized to what we have today, with 8 strikes representing the 8 major islands of Hawaii. And so, with the safety of his
And I think that's gonna be my final point. It's just, this man has so many edits, so many clean cuts that kind of fit together with the beats of his script. Each joke lands, be it visually or in the actual script. Like, this man, he put a lot of different humor elements, a lot of different editing elements, and a lot of different historical elements into this one short little 6 minute 20 video. If there's anyone on YouTube that is really underrated right now, it is Chess Gamone. And like I said, you guys don't have to subscribe if you want to be featured in new videos, but I'm going to subscribe to all of the channels I feature on here because this is great content and it deserves to be recognized. Check out Chess Gamone if you like history and like a laugh. Alright, our next channel for Spotlight is a pretty new channel joined in May 23rd, 2019. We have How to Enjoy Movies. His little description here, his score is just a number. Hey, I'm How to Enjoy Movies, or I review movies, but I never give them a score. Instead, I advise you on how best to watch a film. Should you see it on the big screen, at home with your friends, or do you need to down all the alcohol in your household to make it through? Wow, very... Wow. I am the antithesis of yourmoviesucks.org, which I think is pretty popular. I don't know if I've ever read or seen one of their videos, but my man tries to be funny. I'm just not sure if it's working. Well, I'm here to tell you, my friend, I enjoyed your How To 1917 movie review. So let's see if I'll enjoy this video, which I haven't seen yet. This has been uploaded since I decided I'm going to include his channel. And I guess he does upload every Friday, so consistent content. Can't go wrong with that. Let's see how to enjoy Bad Boys for Life.
In this one, the bad boys want to retire, but after getting into an accident that wasn't their fault, they have to get together for one last ride in order to afford healthcare. Alright guys,
Solid intro. Interesting reference to Fast and Furious, kind of like the intro joke. I'm going to see how to enjoy it for when I do see it.
Gotta be honest with you, I haven't seen Bad Boys 2.
You ain't seen Bad Boys 2?
I know, right? And no, I didn't
want Funny Hot Fuzz reference. You know, he's taken advantage of his wealth of movie knowledge to include little clips from other movies to help add little comedy stings in this video. You know, references to other movies. They always work well on a movie-related channel, so good job.
Previous knowledge of this series, I found the duo of Martin Lawrence and Will Smith incredibly likable. This is why I felt the film was on top. Sure, it's enjoyable, but...
Well, they're likable guys. Love you, Will. And Big Mama's house is alright, Martin.
Damn, are these characters charismatic? The obvious standouts are the bad boys, but honestly, I struggled to find a character I didn't like here. Everyone was just so damn likable.
Joey Pants. Love me some Joey Pants.
He had balls as big as an Irish broad's ass.
If you're here for character development, you're in the wrong place. Go see these films instead.
It's an interesting selection of films. I'm not a big Interstellar guy, but yeah. Some good recommendations.
For the rest of us who are here to see some action, damn, are we in for a good time. How these action scenes build up upon each other, though, is pretty weak. Most movies are structured like this. Bad Boys for Life is structured.
See, I like how he also includes some criticism, like not a lack of character development, lack of a clear act structure, while also giving us positives, likable characters, and well-done action scenes. You know, a good combo of positives and negatives, so it doesn't seem like he's one-sided in an interview.
The score. It's like they did the edit to the temp tracks and then forgot to take the temp tracks out. The only reason I remember this score is because I've already heard...
I also want to point out how in watching this video, it seemed like he hasn't reused a single clip using lots of different pieces and moments from the trailers. Every time he uses one, it usually fits into what he's saying. So really good job making it not repetitive in the use of clips, but also making it relevant to the script.
It's time to talk about the villains. And with that, it's spoiler time. Skip here to hear my recommendation. Bad Boys for Life.
Well, so you guys don't get Bad Boys for Life ruined for you. I appreciate the spoiler mark, and I will skip ahead, because some people aren't considerate. They don't put spoiler warnings, but he did a good job. Very nice and clear. Give us an exact time to skip to. So, props to How to Enjoy Movies.
Funny, but, and big buts here, the jokes that work here are the fast jokes. Almost 90% of you that watch this aren't subscribed, so I urge you to hit that subscribe button if you like what you're currently watching and want to see more. Okay, verdict time.
Wow, absolutely shameless. But I'll do it for you, buddy, because like I said, all this is great content. They deserve the sub. So let's see what his verdict on the movie.
To comment, I would not recommend seeing this in theaters. Not because it's necessarily bad, but because the other movies and theaters are so goddamn good, and this is the weakest choice by default.
Well, he said he wasn't going to give us a score, and he's recommended seeing it with friends. Kind of simplifies the old review process when there's not really a numerical or letter system, and it's just watch it with the boys, watch it in theater, watch it with the girl, whatever. So, you know, I like the simplified format. Really enjoyed the quick, simplistic review, kind of chock full of different little points that need to be hit. You know, the score, the action scenes, the story, the characters. Overall, great movie review channel. Shout out How to Enjoy Movies. Very consistent content, too, every Friday and upload. All right, let's get into the last channel. All right, moving on to the last channel of this episode and our first episode spotlight, we have Degeneration Station, a channel which you can see right here is kind of short on videos. And I will show you why with this newest video from Mr. Generation Station.
Oh yeah, he confessed it all in court because the judge tricked him like, Soulja Boy, tell him, and then he just said everything. He can't help it.
Well, so to start off, I guess the audio in the beginning is a little bit counterbalanced on the Discord, but the whole idea of this video is that him and his friend have a funny, joking conversation while playing a game, and he draws cartoons literally for almost every single comic bit or story beat, and they're all great cartoons, and clearly this is why he has such few videos, because this takes a lot of effort, but overall the result is amazing. So you can see a little bit of his artwork here.
This is the brother bear episode, everybody.
See, look, just for some really throwaway joke, one that another channel probably cut out. This is the Brother Bear episode. Slap a picture of the Brother Bear DVD cover. He does a whole like 4-section cartoon little comic bit that elevates the joke way higher than it would have been otherwise.
The game where one dinosaur fights one man. that's all there is in the entire player base. Ooh.
See, this is a funny joke on the, just without the comics, making fun of the, I guess, player base of Primal Carnage, which I guess if you played Primal Carnage, you would understand, but also people that have played dead multiplayer games before can all relate to. But then the hilarious representation of this poor little shaky man in this giant dinosaur cone form elevates the joke.
Don't worry, I got clips of you laughing that I can put right after that when it's fun.
So right here we have a
farm.
A funny editing joke, because as we learn later, we're like extremely genuine and context laughter, like, okay. And then he explains the joke that he has random sound bits of his friend laughing so he could throw them in whenever. Hilarious editing joke. Well done, too, because you couldn't really tell that it was edits unless he explicitly told us like he did. Another funny editing joke. Elevates a lot of his jokes through the clever edits and the beautiful cartoons. He goes through a lot of different games too, which is fun. He starts off with For Honor, then he goes to the Steam store, then Cuphead. It's a lot of different gameplay. Everything that just gives some sort of background to it, because the main star of the show isn't the gameplay, it's the commentary.
Fortniters is what a sport players call ourselves. Please don't hurt me. Are you older?
See, like, possibly be a weak joke. I'm making fun of Fortnite jokes, than done before, but the subtle adding of a bat into his friend's hand makes it a funny joke. So overall, this channel just really elevates its content. Through these super nice cartoons.
Oh, yeah.
The fun banter between the two.
Down on your ass.
I hope to see a lot more content from him in the future, but clearly, it's like, look how many different unique cartoons he included.
I don't feel like
the effort that goes into these types of videos is probably like at least a whole week worth of work and editing. So we might get more content from him, and it probably will be sparsed out, but maybe he'll start doing some shorter videos to counteract with these longer videos that take more time, maybe some other types of videos. But overall, this is one of the most impressive, I guess, funny moment channels I've seen yet. And like I said, all these channels are getting a sub because all great content. Why don't you sub to Mr. Human Garbage Disposal and his friend, who is also a fellow Human Garbage Disposal. Hope you guys enjoyed this first episode of the Spotlight series with Degeneration Station, How to Enjoy Movies, and Chest Gemon. So give these guys a look if you enjoyed their content. I think they're all working their butts off to make some great videos, and leave your channel down below if you want me to check that out for a future episode. See you guys in the next one.
For my life, can't say that, girl, don't tell me you can say that shit. All she want is payback for the way I always play that shit.